We're here with Steven Chavez, aka Steph Chavez, one of the Altium podcast alumni. Who are you excited to see?
For me, it's just to see everyone back face to face. I mean, you know, I'm getting chills just thinking about it. You know, the fact that we're all here and the buzz is still here and getting back into the groove of attending the conference and education is unbelievable. So.
To the presentation this morning of the two fab guys talking about the 21 mistakes they catch all the time in the fab shops.
You know, 21 mistakes seems like a lot of really common mistakes. Was any of it surprising to you?
Not a bit.
Any women in the industry, so it's like you're always surrounded by a whole bunch of men, and then, you know, like how do you deal with like finding your confidence, or like how long did it take for you to be like more secure and have a good foundation?
We make the world's only 3D printer that uses two materials, which would be by definition the only multi-layer capable machine in the world. It's truly 3D printers. We think about RF boards that have stubs. There are no stubs. When people come to us and say, hey, you print a 20, how many layer board can you do? We say 20 layers, but but it's really 20,000 layers, right? You get to do whatever you want in the Z-axis.
This is actually using mechanical milling, 1/8 inch tungsten carbide tooling. This system is manual tool change, manual depth calibration. We do have more advanced milling machines that have 15 or 20 position automatic tool changes. So with those systems, you can load in your Gerber DXF data, hit start, walk away, go home for the day, go to lunch, and come back to have a completed printed circuit board.
That's awesome. I mean, you literally just open up the files, click a few buttons, and you're going.
Exactly.
It's fun to realize that our industry is alive and well, right? It is booming in the United States. Materials, boards, fabrication, assembly, you name it. This is a great time to be here. It's a great time to be at this show.
The market that we are in is shrinking. So there used to be 5,000 vendors. Now there's like 150 in the United States. And of that 150, you really have about 25 or 30 that can build advanced technology.
As you know, there were a couple of talks really looking at emerging technologies. And so guys that haven't had, or designers who haven't had anybody from the outside coming into their facilities for the last couple of years now got a good look at printed electronics or additive manufacturing. They heard a lot about different laminates. They heard about some AI stuff, which is completely new to them. So there's a whole bunch of new technologies that they got exposed to.